comes in, he has to defend really well. He's a really talented offense, but you got to really focus on defense and keep making mistakes. Just going to make you pay. So it's going to be a great matchup. It's going to be a tough matchup.
What about the other semifinal?
It's going to be a great battle. Honestly, I haven't really paid that much attention. You know, I know both teams, obviously, but we're going to focus on one game at a time, and whatever happens, the game happens. But I know it's going to be a great game.
Tell me about your selection in the second year of LinkedIn.
Yeah, you know, it's an honor. It feels great to be a
part of it.
You know, I didn't even think it that far ahead. I wasn't thinking of that point.
We were talking about guards back in Korea, if you remember.
Yeah.
And you couldn't pick one.
Yeah, no, that's the thing. There's some great players in Euroleague, so I just try to live in the moment, focus on what I can do right at that time. And, if I get recognized, it's great. And in this case, I did, so maybe it's an honor, but that's not what this final four is about.
Do you believe that for you and Paul, you as a player, that please, that you were selecting the second Euroleague team, this is a crowning achievement? For what you have achieved this year? Is there recognition?
Yeah, I think it's great. But at the same time, you know, I think anyone on our team could be deserving. Every game there's someone different that steps up. So I think people on our team were deserving, and whoever it was, it didn't really matter because that's part of our team. Every night there's someone different that steps up. So not for myself and Yankee, but also for our team.
How does your team manage to be so effective behind the 3-point line? You're the team with the less attempted 3-pointers and the most effective, you know, 42.4% from the
effective. I think it's saying that you take your shots, shot selection without forcing many games. You're taking high percentage shots, you're going to make more hard percentage. So that's probably, you know, the best explanation I can have. Guys get in the gym and practice, obviously, but just taking good shots.
You know, you're facing the practicing the best defense in the competition.
Our,
much
our defense, or facing
defense.
Yeah, no, they're a great defense. You know, they're long, athletic, tough. They play hard. We're trying to do that. A great defense team. Just gotta, you know, play the team more around.
Austin Griffin, your really good Vikings podcast. First time you guys played Fenerbahce, it seemed like they were trying to attack you a lot in the post. Guys like Datome, Guterich, these big guys, a lot of size. How do you handle the size when these guys try to attack you in the post as a smaller guy?
Yeah, just battles. That's normal. You know, I've been this height for a while now, so I've kind of gotten pretty used to it. But you know, I gotta do my part to make it difficult. But then my team's also gonna help me as well. So. On our team on defense, we never leave one guy on an island. One guy gets two, next guy helps him out, next guy helps him out. So, that's pretty normal, but again, I'm getting ready for it.
Yeah, for sure. I think it's fair to say this is obviously the best season of your pro career. I think a lot of people kind of point to Yasikevich is having a big role in that. Obviously, you've done a ton of work by yourself, but like what is it about Saris that kind of brings out the best in guys?
I think this is his level of expectation. The standard he sets for guys is he wants them to be their best. And over 2 years I've seen he's really good at picking the things that guys need to work on the most. I'm really stressed about it. Sometimes it's not enjoyable because he's not playing well and not doing so well at those things, but it really forces me to bring it out of you. So it's been great for me to challenge myself and ask what I'm weak at and get better with that.
Yeah. Do you guys work a lot together personally? Like, seems like you've kind of picked up some little tricks here and there. Like, you've got that little, like, that same foot floater, like, left foot, left hand floater type of thing that you maybe, like, didn't quite have before. Have you kind of, like, picked up some tricks here and there from him?
Yeah, he'll be talking to me about some shots here and there and stuff. But those are also things that over the years I've kind of watched guys and different coaches I've had that have tried to do different things. So that's just an accumulation of a bunch of different teams and coaches and players I've watched. But, definitely talking to him a lot, you know, practice and just trying to relay, you know, a lot of strategy in my mind. So I was trying to be
Kevin Emmett Ryan from Ball in Europe. Your link up with Brandon this year has been fantastic to watch for those of us from at home. What's it like for you, like working alongside him, having been against him in the college ranks, of course?
Against who, sir?
Brandon.
Oh, yeah. No, we were like rivals in college, you know, so we played against each other a bunch. But now playing with him, he's a great player. Easy to play with. He rolls hard and has good hands for a big guy. So it's been great to play with him. He's gotten a lot better throughout the season, so it's been great for him.
And are you looking forward to people stop asking you what it's like to be an underdog?
Yeah, honestly. But at the same time, people can ask what they can ask. It doesn't matter. In our locker room, we believe, and that's all that matters. So That underdog label, it gets tossed around all the time, and